eyes haven't seen, nor of my ears heard, what my Father has in store. But when I hear the sound of a sweet singing bird, I'm closer than I've been before to that heavenly home built by God alone, according to His perfect plan, where the only thing there that's been made by man are the scars in the hands of Jesus. Well, I'm headed for a home built by God alone. Hallelujah, praise the Lord, I am where the only thing there that's been made by man are the scars in the hands of Jesus. When I see a mountain covered with snow that's fallen from heaven above, well, it makes me feel small, hardly nothing at all, to know that I'll be a part of that mansion world where the gates of pearl of Jesus. Yes, the only thing there that's been made by man are the scars in the hands of my Savior. Walking down the road to Jerusalem, the time had come to sacrifice again. My two small sons, they walked beside me on the road. The reason they came was to watch the Lamb. Daddy, Daddy, what will we see there? There's so much that we don't understand. So I told them of Moses and Father Abraham. Then I said, dear children, watch the Lamb. There'll be so many in Jerusalem today. We must be sure the Lamb doesn't run away. And I told them of Moses, Father Abraham. Then I said, dear children, watch the Lamb. When we reached the city, I knew something must be wrong. There were no joyful worshipers, no joyful worship songs. I stood there with my children in the midst of angry men. Then I heard the crowd cry out, crucify him! Thank you. tried to leave the city, but we could not get away. Forced to play in this drama, a part I did not wish to play. Why upon this day were men condemned to die? Why were we standing here where soon they would pass by? I looked and said, even now they come. The first one cried for mercy, the people gave him none. The second one was violent, he was arrogant and loud. I can still hear his angry voice screaming at the crowd. Then someone said, there's Jesus. I scarce believe my eyes. A man so badly beaten, he barely looked alive. Blood poured from his body, from the thorns on his brow, running down the cross and falling to the ground. I watched him struggle, I watched him fall. The cross came down upon his back, the crowd began to yell. Until at a moment, a Roman soldier grabbed my arm. He screamed. Carry his cross. At first I tried resisting, but his hand reached for his sword. So I knelt and took the cross from the Lord. I placed it on my shoulder and started down the street. The blood that he'd been shedding was running down my cheek. They led us to Golgotha. They drove nails in his feet and hands. Yet upon the cross I heard him pray, Father, forgive them. Oh, never have I seen such love in any other eyes. Into thy hands I commit my spirit. He prayed and then he died. I stood for what seemed years. I'd lost all sense of time. Till I felt two tiny hands holding tight to mine. My children stood there weeping. I heard the oldest say, Father, please forgive us. The lamb ran away. Daddy, Daddy, what have we seen here? There's so much that we don't understand. So I took them in my arms. We turned and faced the cross. And I said, dear children, watch the Lamb.